Be anxious for nothing. You know, all of God's children have some irrational anxiety too. How anxiety gets us all tied up in knots. Just wake up in a big bundle of nothing but dread. Spend half your day just unknotting your emotions. Just wake up feeling that way sometimes. You ever felt nearly swamped in your life? Like, I'm still showing up, but barely. I'm making it and I'm smiling, but nobody knows what's really behind this smile. The things I think about, some days I just want to run away from it all. It's kind of hard to talk about peace and being unanxious when all you see around you is bars and iron. And feel like you're already surrounded by problems, by pressures, and by predicaments that are left over from the night before. Maybe you thought you weren't a courageous person, but you just did not know how to access the courage that God had planted inside of you. There are some things that you're afraid of. There are some things that are causing you to shut down. They're paralyzing you. Some winds are blowing and some waves are breaking and some things are happening and some uncertainties popping up and some difficulties you're facing and you don't know what to do. And you wonder, don't you care? Aren't you supposed to be the one who keeps my life out of trouble? But you told me to get in the boat. So it kind of bothered me that he sent them into a storm. Sometimes we create our own storms, though, don't we? See, some waves are God-ordained in our lives. But some waves are waves we make, and sometimes we create our own anxiety, and then we ask God for peace. But how can he give you peace in the situation that you're currently creating? Often we create anxiety and waves in our lives with the words that we speak. Words of doubt, words of some of you, just you frame your day with the wrong words. And then you're disappointed with the world that you've built, but your world is created by your words. Sometimes it's not what we're going through, it's the way we're going through what we're going through. Some of us live with no margin, and so we're always nervous. It's our approach. Anxious about money because we spend too much and don't make enough. No margin. It's your approach. You start your morning frustrated with people in traffic. You know there's going to be traffic. You've never adjusted the time that you get up and leave your house. Now you're wondering why your job is so stressful. Your job is not stressful. The way you got to your job was stressful because of your approach. The wrong voices can create unnecessary and needless waves and anxiety in our lives, can't they? Man, if you check the news or your Twitter feed on your phone before even getting up to use the bathroom in the morning, and you wonder why the outlook on life that you have is so dark, I think 24/7 news stations and news is one of the worst things that ever happened to our peace of mind as people. Do you really need to understand the dynamics of every disease? Like every disease? Do you really need to understand the dynamics of every conflict in all these countries that you can't pronounce? You're marinating in the wrong reports, the wrong voices. But I don't need so much information that it clouds my outlook, so I can't let the wrong voices just keep on playing, keep on going, and then they say this, and then they do that, and they might do that, and it could be that. You know, at some point you just gotta say, I'm creating waves by all the voices I'm listening to. I listen to depression, I watch depression, the people I hang around are depressing, I'm making my own waves. Our expectations can create waves. Don't be surprised. You need to learn to expect some storms. I think the fact that it's unexpected is often the reason it's so difficult. The master wave maker in our souls is called shame. You walk around anxious because you're hiding stuff. And you wonder, when are they gonna find out about my secret? or maybe because you're tormented by something that God already forgave. See, there's a difference between conviction and shame. Conviction is good. It shows you what to fix, and it gives you God's power to help fix it. Shame tells you that because of what you did, who you are is now fundamentally changed, and it makes you walk around paranoid, and it makes you walk around feeling helpless, and it makes you walk around feeling like people don't love you who do love you, and people are judging you that aren't judging you. You gotta learn where to take your shame, where to just rock you. Waves. Why are you so afraid? Don't you know that when I tell you we're going to the other side, we're gonna get to the other side? Don't you know that I command the wind and the waves? And see, they didn't yet. They hadn't seen enough yet. They hadn't experienced enough. I want to suggest something to you today about the storms of anxiety in your life and the waves and the winds that are blowing in your life. Because, man, the winds will blow. They will blow. Absolutely. And the waves will break and they will crash. No doubt about it. When Jesus is sleeping in the stern and he doesn't take action and he doesn't fix your situation, it can be easy to deduce what the disciples deduce. We're going to die and God doesn't even care. Yeah. And see, I wonder, all week, why would Jesus send them into a storm? Just like we wonder in our lives, why doesn't God do more about the chaos in our world? Why doesn't he fix situations before they get that bad? But we wonder, why did God have to make it so that people die and we feel pain and sorrow? Don't you care? And Jesus was upset about that. You know what? I don't think he was upset that they woke him up. I think they were supposed to wake him up. I think he wanted them to go wake him up. I do. I think it's the way they woke him up that bothered him. See, because they woke him up thinking, you must not care. You don't care. He said in Philippians 4:6, didn't he? In everything, make your requests known to God. You're supposed to ask God. I believe that Jesus put him in the storm, not to test him, but to teach him. And so I think Jesus, when he stood up and he said, quiet, be still, and the wind and the waves died down. You know what I think he was doing? I think he was using the wind and the waves like a whiteboard to draw a lesson plan. Because the real waves that take you down in your life are not the ones out there. They're the ones in here. And see, you think it's the circumstance that's making you anxious. It's not. You think it's the other person's reaction. You think the problem is that God won't calm the waves without. The real problem is you haven't learned to calm the waves within. But that's why God lets me experience winds and waves in my life. So he can teach me to calm the wind and the waves within. See, the real waves are within. And you'll never have peace until you learn how to speak peace to the waves within. So Jesus said, watch this. He said, be still. And the waves shut up. And he said, now it's your turn. What I just did to the sea, I want you to do to your anxious heart. And the next time the winds of what if start blowing and the winds of imaginary scenarios and negative emotions start blowing, I want you to get up and wake up your faith from the stern of the ship and get out and hold up your hand and say, quiet, be still. You're supposed to go down to the stern and say, Lord, I need a little help right now. Lord, this doesn't feel good. God is pushing against me. God is getting cloudy. I don't know what to think. And the sky's grown black. Would you help me, Lord? Would you come, Lord? But don't assume he doesn't care.
The words and the approach and the voices and the expectations and the shame, that's the waves. And when the waves come, because they will, just as soon as the wave comes, breathe. Remember, comes embarrassment. Here come words. Here come actions. Here come voices. Here come expectations.